The second kos of the four kosot is Baruch Ata Hashem Asher Ga'alanu, that He redeemed us, the Goal Et Avoseinu B'Mitzrayim, and He redeemed our forefathers from Mitzrayim. And the next words are Ve'igiyanu, and He helped us arrive Alayla Hazeh, to this evening, Lechol Bo Matzah Umaro, so that we have the privilege of eating Matzah Umaro. That's a bracha. The Rishonim explain that the concept of this bracha is because the mitzvah of Sipur Yitzias Mitzrayim, of the narrative of Yitzias Mitzrayim, involves, like the Mishnah says, Bechol Dor V'Dor, in every generation a person, it's incumbent on every person, Lirot Et Atzmo, or like the Rambam writes, L'harot Et Atzmo, Ki'ilu Hu Yatzah Mitzrayim, or Ki'ilu Hu Atzmo Yatzah Mitzrayim, or Ki'ilu Hu Atzmo Yatzah Ze'ata, right now, Yitzias Mitzrayim. So the mitzvah of Yitzias Mitzrayim is, on the night of Pesach, we reenact, we relive in a live reenactment the actual Yitzias Mitzrayim. I'm a Yotzeh Mitzrayim. I'm sitting with my family at the Seder. I'm sitting with my friends. We're leaving Mitzrayim this moment. And that's a bracha which every time a person revisits a spot where he had a miracle, he makes the bracha. And in the last perek in Masecht Brachot, perek aroeh makom shenase lo nes, he sees a place where HaKadosh Baruch Hu made with him a miracle, so he makes a bracha, Baruch shasa li nes b'makom hazeh. You had a highway, and hodu l'Hashem Yizbarach Shemo, you had a car accident, Rachmana Litzlan. And it had the possibility, and it had the ability to be fatal, Rachmana Litzlan. And Hashem saved you. You came out without a scratch. The car turned over, the car was totaled, and thank God you came out perfect. So you make a bracha anytime you pass that spot, 30 days without being there for 30 days. You make the bracha she'asah li nes b'makom hazeh. When a Jew arrives at the spot called the night of the 15th day of Nisan, and it's at night, this is the night of b'chatzi alayla. B'chatzi alayla Hashem yika kol b'chor. And you come to that moment, you make bracha she'asah li nes b'makom hazeh. So how do we do that? By saying a bracha, Asher Ga'alanu V'Ga'al Et Avoseinu Mimitzrayim. But the rabbis have a policy. You learn Tosafot, the Rishonim, many times. They don't combine, it's even Gemara, you don't combine two different thank yous to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in one bracha. So it's two different things. The Biracha and the Geula of Mitzrayim, this huge miracle, this tremendous miracle of Yitziat Mitzrayim. And we're also giving thanks that we were Zoche once again to have this tremendous mitzvah of Matzah Maro. How did the two of them come together in one bracha? How do you bring into a bracha, which is giving thanks for a nes of Yitziat Mitzrayim, and adding a thank you for the privilege of doing the mitzvah again, a matzah maror? That's like a shechiyanu bracha. Besides the question that we already made shechiyanu by the first kiddush, when we make kiddush, we say shechiyanu, and you're supposed to have in mind all the mitzvot you're going to do that night. Is it without shechiyanu? Not only the bracha on the holiday, it's the bracha on the first kos and the dalet kosot, and the mitzvah of matzah, maror, sipur yitziat mitzrayim, all the mitzvot that we're going to do that night has one yud shechiyanu. What is the second time? Igiyanu alayla zeh lechol bo matzah umaror. And that is a tremendous insight. What are we thanking for on the night of Pesach? We're thanking that our nation was saved from an oppressive situation in Egypt, in Mitzrayim, where we were working like on a plantation in Mississippi, and we were picking cotton for the Arabs. And thank God we don't have to do that anymore. And we were learning all the bad habits of the Arabs. And thank God we don't have to learn that, we don't have to do that anymore. Yes, definitely Pesach is a thank you for the collective Geulah and for the collective Pulkan Kehayom Hazeh that HaKadosh Baruch Hu did with the Jewish people. But that starts in the morning. Because that's the time when the Jewish people came out of Mitzrayim was Be'Safra, in the morning. It's a Pasuk. Hotzi be'etzem hayom hazeh, HaKadosh Baruch Hu took out the Bnei Yisrael al tzivotam, all 600,000 of us. We're the Legion Shel Melech, we're God's army. That happened in the morning of Pesach. The Rishonim teach us. If you really study well, it's the portion of the Torah which we read on the first day Pesach, which recites the question that in the Agadah is brought down in the name of the Rasha. Mo avodah zot lachem. And the answer that the Torah says, V'amartem zevach Pesach hu l'Hashem, if you study very well a few lines of the Holy Rishon, Sipuna ala Torah, Rabbi Avadya Sipuna ala Torah in Parshat Bo, you see that he says that's not what we're thanking for in the evening. What we're thanking for at midnight, what we're thanking for in the night of Pesach, is for each individual member in Am Yisrael giving thanks to Hashem for what he was zochetu, for what he became, what he received this night. Sure, God took out all the Jews from Mitzrayim, and he assembled us as a nation, and he brought us to Sinai to get the Torah. And he crossed the ocean with us, the sea. He split the sea for us. All that is true for us as a collective nation. But every individual Jew, young and old, like it says in the Hallel, Ani avdecha ben amatecha. I'm the servant, the son of your woman servant, my mother. David HaMelech says, Pitachta, you undid limoserai, to my own bondage. That night, HaKadosh Baruch Hu handpicked 600,000 people individually. He went from house to house. The Malach HaMashchit, wherever there was blood on the mezuzah, he skipped over, he passed over that house. Kol bechoreim arakta uvechor chagalta. Every single one of us. And that happened on the night of Pesach. So if I sit Pesach, I had to say that with my four cups, and I do my matzah, my maror, besides what's going on tonight on a global scale with Am Yisrael, but me, the individual, that every morning I say in prayer, Shalom asani goy, but I say it quickly. Or we say in Aleinu L'Shabeach, Shelo asanu ki goyei o arotzot, velo samanu ki shpichot o adama, Shelo sam chalkeinu kahem, v'goraleinu kechol amonam. Pesach night, the whole mitzvah is to internalize. I am chosen. Hashem chose me. Now each and every one of us, we are family and friends that unfortunately don't understand what's happening on Pesach. We all went to school with chaverim. We had friends, chaverim and chaverot. Many of them don't keep Shabbat. Many of them lost it all. Some of them are sucked into the melting pot of America. But we're not. Where Hashem gave us this chacham, the third chacham, or he sent us Rabbi Walkin, Alav HaShalom, whatever it is. But we're sitting on a weekday morning when the whole world is out there making money. We're sitting here in the Midrash, listening to Divrei Torah to get inspired. Do you know what that means? We're our cousins. We're our siblings. We're our friends right now. Making money at best. At worst, they're doing much worse things than making money. Why are we here? How do we get here? Every single one of us has a journey that's 3,200 years old. It all started the night of Pesach. Asher ga'alanu v'ga'al et avoseinu mimitzrayim. But where did it get us to? That I'm zocheh to eat matzah shmura. I'm not taking off something in the A&P off the shelf for $9.99 a box. I'm in Rabbi Walkin's Kihila. I'm Yerei Shamayim. I get matzah that was specially made for the night of Pesach. I don't go haggle about the price. I get matzah, I get maror, kosher maror. No worms on my maror. I don't buy maror off the shelf. And I buy kosher maror. Maror like my mother used, like my grandma used, like they used in the old country. Because anavda dekucha berichu. That's my fame, that's all I am. I'm anavda dekucha berichu. The only person I tremble for is him. For the Torah Kedosha. That's a 3,200 year derasha journey. It's gone through many, many galuyot. From Mitzrayim we came to the Holy Land. We had the first Mikdash. It only lasted 400 years. We were kicked out because of Avonot. So we went to Bavel. And in Bavel we were 70 years, and in the middle happened the story with Haman. We came back to Yerushalayim for our second Mikdash. And again Avonoteinu, we had Chanukah, this huge nes of Chanukah. And then again we were kicked out of the second Mikdash. And it's been 2,000 years. We've been here and we've been there. And you guys were in Uzbekistan, where your parents were. Okay, how'd you get to Uzbekistan? There were no 747s in those days. So you had to go to this place and to that place. I don't even know the history. How long were the Jews in Uzbekistan? 1,000 years, more? Where'd they come from? They're there from Beit Sheni. 2,000 years. And who would believe that Hashem may turn the world over and you guys end up in Queens? And it's Hashem. Where are we going to be next year? The Shana Ba'a, all of us, B'simchat Olam Al Roshenu. So let me say, we just went through a year of Corona. And like we just heard from the rabbi, this shul, Yetomim Ayinu Ve'enav, the Ateret Roshenu was taken from us, the crown. In many kihilot, the crown was taken. Chasidim, Lo Chasidim, Ashkenazim, Sephardim, the crowns of many, many kihilot were removed. But let's think the flip side. I'll give you a different thing that we say in Tefillah, and one of the highlights of Pesach night. It's called Birchat Hashir. You guys know what Birchat Hashir is? Which prayer is Birchat Hashir? So the Gemara teaches us it's Nishmat. Nishmat is called in the Gemara Birchat Hashir, and Birchat Hashir is one of the obligations of the night of Pesach. After we do Birchat HaMazon, Nishmat Kol Chai, Tivarech Hashimcha. So David goes like this. Ilufinu Malei Shirak Hayom. If our mouths would have been full of song, as big as the ocean, the volume of the song that we want to say, that our mouths are full with, is as big as the ocean. If my mouth would be as wide and as big as the ocean, Kayam. V'sifseinu shevach kemecha v'rakia. And my lips have the ability to move like the whole sky. V'yadeinu p'chusot kenishrei shamayim. And our hands are spread out like the eagles of the sky. V'ragleinu kalot ka'ayalot. And our feet are as a speedy deer. Ein anachnu maspikim. We still are not able to do justice. Lehodot lecha, to thank you, Hashem Elokeinu, Elokei Avoteinu, and the God of our parents. Al achas, for one little may alef elef alfei alafim. How much is that? Elef al elef alef. That's a million. Alfei alafim. A million of a million. How much is that? It's almost as much as Biden is spending. Spending. What he's charging to the account. Charging. V'ribei revavot. Pe'amim. Atovot. She'asita. La'avoteinu v'imanu. Which is the very first thing God did for us. Mimitzrayim gi'altanu Hashem Elokeinu. Okay, that happened how many years ago? That happened 3,000 and some hundred years ago. But how do we get from then to here? So then the Bala, the Chazala Ketoshim, the Anshei Knesset Agdola add, he fed us every single day since then till today. God feeds us. So for 3,200 years, he's been sustaining us. Because if we wouldn't have had food, we would have died from hunger. Many, many of us had nice businesses. And still do. What do we say in the Ishamda? Lo echad bilvad amad aleinu lechaloteinu. How many times in your old country did the Goyim want to kill us? How many pogroms were there? And wherever a Jew lived, there was amdim aleinu lechaloteinu. There was no place in the world that Jews found as a safe haven. There was no place. It was good for a few years, then it got bad. Mecherev itzaltanu. Then umideva milatetanu. What does that mean? What is umideva milatetanu? When God sent a plague, He sent a pandemic. If we're here today, someone survived that pandemic. Do we have to go back to history? We're all here. Everybody here looks healthy. Everybody here has relatives that were affected very badly by the pandemic. Many of you were probably sick yourself. I didn't hear that Queens didn't have any cholim. But, just like the night of Pesach, the Malach HaMashchis, this house yeah, this house no. In the same house, this person yes, this person no. Those of us that are going to sit at the Seder this year, how can we not realize that midever milatetanu? And if we got sick, those of us that really got sick and are here tonight at the Seder, mechalayim ra'im v'nemanim delitanu. Do we think about it? Do we walk around with that feeling that the reason we didn't get symptoms, or we got slight symptoms, or we got recoverable symptoms, or even if we were very sick, we got healthy, is because Mideva Milatetanu, Umichaloim Raim Venemanim Dilitanu. That's how you're supposed to think of Ga'alanu Vega'alet Avotzeinu Mimitzrayim. V'higiyanu alayla zeh. This was a huge journey. There were so many little stops on this journey, so many potential exits, that he kept us on the highway and he didn't let us get off on the exit. So many of us got off. Whether they got off physically or worse, they got off spiritually. If all of us would have stayed on the highway, we would have been a nation of trillions. We're a little nation with 12 million people, 13 million people, 14 million people, out of a world of 7 billion. Because all of us got off the highway. We are the ones that Hashem ga'alanu v'ga'alat avoteinu v'higiyanu. We're here. Because we went through the whole nishmat. But you know what it's all about? Big deal, so we're here. What are we here for? There's a lot of people living in Queens. There's a lot of people living in the Jewish communities of Queens. I'm not here to talk against Jews. But what kind of life do they have? Big deal that God spared them. He spared them to be nightclub goers? He spared them to waste their days away? He spared them to run after all the stupid enjoyments of this world? That's what he spared them 3,200 years ago and held their hand and held their hand and held their hand on this long travel, on this long journey of Higiyanu. But we know what it's about because we were zocheh to have teachers. And we still have teachers. Lo'orech yamim v'shanim tovot. We know what this journey is about. Ba'avur zeh asa Hashem li, b'tzeiti mimitzrayim, Rashi HaKadosh says, ba'avur she'akayem mitzvotav. He didn't take us out so we should go play golf. He doesn't begrudge you a few hours of golf to chill on a Sunday afternoon so you should be able to air your hair out to come to the shiur tomorrow with a clearer head. If you need to do a little bit olam hazeh, he lets you. He loves us. He knows that we're only human. We're not made out of plastic. Maybe Rabbi Wolkin was made out of plastic. But we're plain people. But that's what we were born for? And that's why he watched us for this long journey? That's the meaning of the Baracha. Of course we're thanking on the miracle. But what's the miracle worth if all I do with the miracle is be an enjoy lifer? Figuring out the latest restaurant or the latest thing where you could get a bottle of whiskey for $1,200 or a wine that costs $1,700. Wow. That's called the jackpot. That's what we're here for. V'higiyanu alayla azeh lechol bo matza'a maro. And what's the answer that the father gives to the Ben HaChacham? Ma'i dud v'achukim v'mishpatim asher. Va'af. You know what's the best answer you could give him what tonight is all about? Tell him, what did your Rebbe teach you in school? Tell me a good kushya about Pesach that your Rebbe told you in school. And the kid asks, and the father goes to adult shiurim, so he knows enough to answer. That moment makes the whole trip worth it. Because ner is mitzvah, but Torah is more than mitzvah. Torah or. Torah is the light itself. So all of us do matzah maror. But a lucky kid, a Ben Chacham, and the father appreciates what it means to have a Ben Chacham. So he tells him, Tzion, what did your Rebbe teach you today? Let me hear something about a good kushya. And Tzion tells his father a good kushya. And the father learned, and he, in my shiur I heard today, this is an argument that Kaf HaChayim and Mishnah Brura. Ooh, that's fire. My Rebbe didn't tell me, my Rebbe did tell me this and this, and the house lights up with Esha Torah. That's Yitziat Mitzrayim. That's the really Giyanu Alayla Azeh Lechol Bo Matzah Umaro. It's not just Matzah Umaro. It's Matzah with the understanding what Matzah represents. It's Maro with the representative, with representing what Maro represents. And then, what bursts from our hearts is Ashreinu Matov Chalkeinu Umanayim Goraleinu Umayafa Yerushateinu. And that moment, we appreciate the gift of Atah Bechartanu Mikol HaAmim, the gift of She'ansani Yisrael. Thank you, Hashem, that you brought me into your army and you gave me the chance to be your Evet. Avadai Heim, Velo Avadim LaAvadim, which is Zocheh Lachog Et Chag HaMatzot B'Simcha U'V'Tuv Leivav. And hopefully, if God forbid Mashiach does not come before Pesach, when Eliyahu HaNavi knocks on our doors, he should tell us the Besorot Tova. We should hear Besorach Haman, Lezakenu Limot HaMashiach L'Chayei Olam Haba.